Hello everyone, JVC1103 here. Welcome back to some more Project Calls 3. Today we're here at Imola and we're going to do another GT Open Race. Because I just love upgrading my cars to its full potential if you can, you know, upgrade them. As we go through the field, as you can see, we're going to be playing with the Lamborghini Hurricane Rana GT3. Alright, let's get this started. And yeah, you saw the weather. The engine's gonna be quite interesting. Yeah, shit in the middle! Thanks, boys! Oh, ladies. All the way. We have taken the lead. Gotta make hay while the time is good. Don't keep drifting, don't keep drifting. Alrighty. Somehow we are pulled away. We're going to be at the lap one. Oh, come on, that wasn't a corner master. But that was all right, game. All right. And that too. Really, this game sometimes. Yeah, if you haven't noticed, it's kind of raining right now. I like doing these videos kind of in bulk. Just didn't expect it to rain today and be raining heavily at times. Seriously, if we can just get the electronics fixed and that smoke alarm. But with all the COVID, yep, you can't get everyone out here. So far, we're pulling away. Come on. Come on. Oh. Over dribbled a little too much right there. Some hybrid right there. Come on. I'm gonna use half right there. We're gonna have a very good breaking zone to make up some hybrid. Beginning to break, and there we go. Clouds are rolling in. Was that a little bit of a water spike?
Wet, so it will be slippery. Dial yourself into the conditions.
Wow, this is like one thing I would kind of complain about. I kind of like to give us the option for the weather. But I kind of wish they would have still gave us at least three pull, like in the other two project cars, gave us four slots for weather. It just feels too instant in this game. Like, I enjoy playing it. It just don't feel like a numbered project cars game. I can understand trying to make a game accessible, and I'm kind of glad they did, since, you know, Project Cars 1 and 2, it kind of didn't hit the marks as a sim. It's a weird thing. Sim fans upset with this game, but they're not upset, but they didn't really promote Project Cars 1 and 2 that much. They try to make it accessible for everyone. Some fans are mad because it's not like Project Cars 1 and 2. It's kind of a weird thing. And you got people like me in the middle that just, you know, enjoyed it for what it was. For mostly just wish it would have better, you know, controls for pad and also a little bit more improved handling. Which this game, in a way, kind of does. It's very playable on pad, as you can see. Unlike the other two games. One was just atrocious. Two was an improvement, but that's just not by much. But seriously, I keep saying this like a broken record. I kind of wish that they just chose tracks with pit roads, had a max number of maybe 30 cars to every track, and just did tire stops, and just strictly just stayed the race cars, because it would have helped the game a lot more, and also clean up the classes. If you needed upgrades, just make them, you know, doable or sensible. As much as I like having a max car, if I can upgrade it to max, some of the car classes are a little wonky. Just gotta keep it on the tarmac. As the track deteriorates literally corner by corner right now. No, get back on track, please. Please get back on track. Now the gap is under 2 seconds. Remember when I said the track was deteriorating corner by corner? It's deteriorating corner by corner. Kind of wishing I had that weather extra one or two weather slots right now. I really don't want this race to end in the rain, especially with water patches like that. And I think we gotta do 2 more laps. Ooh, that was close. Oh, come on. Had to drift down a corner exit. And then here, the car just goes too wide. After hitting a hydroplane. I can feel the grip going away, game. Oh, it's gonna be fun playing this game back in cockpit view. No! No! We are not having that, sir. You will stay behind me. No. Come on. Hybrid, help me out. I know that's a GT1.
Almost there. Final lap now.
We got ourselves a battle here, boys and girls. We got ourselves a battle. Hey! Chill out with that, sir, kind person. Looking for the hybrid right now. Oh, come on. We cannot make a mistake in this little section right here. Oh, we do, because it went wide. Oh, come on. Oh, don't push. Oh my goodness. Oh, come on. Come on, Ibit. Start at third. And we're gonna come home third.
Great driving. See you on the podium.
Oh. This is why I wish we, at least, if we just could have changed tires. Yeah, there wasn't nothing wrong with just at least, and they would just say, oh, we're just going to keep top. Just do like Gran Turismo 1 through 3, where you just change tires. It wouldn't be no problem. And then also, maybe a little bit of career changing to cope with that. But still, just little things. But we at least got on the podium. So it wasn't all that bad. Like I said, I do enjoy this game, but I'm not going to downplay that. Yeah, there's some problems. I just really wish that they can learn from the positives of this and just improve on things. Because I really do enjoy this game. This is my favorite of the Project Cars series. Onto the podium. Well, at least an Italian car got on the podium. Got some corners mastered. And that would be it for this video. I'm JVC1103. Thanks for watching. Leave a like and whole comment. And if you did enjoy what you saw today, consider subscribing for more gameplay content. Until the next video, be safe, everyone, and peace.